Okay, so the botanical name of oil palm. Ilias chunensis belongs to the family Palmi or Arecaceae. Basically, oil palm is cultivated for the purpose is production of palm oil. The oil palm is originated from West Africa where it is growing wild and later develop into the agricultural crop. So oil palm is cultivated for the commercial production from palm olive. It is also called as palm oil and commercially palm olive. Okay, and origin of oil palm is West Africa. Firstly, it is cultivated as wild crop, then develop into agricultural crop. It is the tropical palm tree. The species, there are mainly two species better known. One is originated from Junia, Africa, and was first illustrated by Nicholas Jacquin in 1763. Hence, its name is Ilias Junensis Jack. Other species is Ilias olerifera. It is native to tropical Central America and South America. There are two main species of oil palm mostly cultivated. First is Ilias junensis and second one is the Ilias olerifera. This is the palm olive tree. Mature tree are single stem and grow to a 20 meter tall. The leaves are pinnate and reach between 3 to 5 meter long. The young tree produce about 30 leaves a year. Established of tree over 10 years produce about 20 leaves a year. This is a single stem tree and the height of the tree is 20 meter tall. Okay, the leaves is 3 to 5 meter between and then long. The young tree produces about 20 to 30 leaves per year. An established year over 30 years produce about 20 leaves a year. Oil palm is a crop that bears about both male and female flowers on the same tree, meaning they are monoecious. Okay, this is the monoecious tree. And the flowers are producing a dense cluster. Each individual flower is a small with three sepals and three petals. So the flowering of this tree is in a cluster form. The trunk of young and adult plants are wrapped in a fronds which give them a rather thick appearance. Older tree have smoother trunk apart from the scars left by the fronds which have withered and fallen off. Each tree produces compact bunch, that is tendon, weighing between 20 to 25 kilograms with 1000 to 3000 fruitlets per bunch. This is the fruit of oil palm. Each fruitlet is almost spherical and elongated in a shape. Generally, the fruitlet is dark purple, almost black, and then color turns to orange red when ripe. Okay, this is the fruit of oil palm. First, it is dark purple color, almost black color, and then at the time of maturity, they turns the color to orange red. Each fruitlet consists of oily, fleshy outer layer, the pericarp, with a single seed kernel, also rich in oil. This is the internal structure of oil palm. Okay, the oily fleshy outer layer. This is the fleshy outer layer with single seed kernel. This is the single seed kernel. Okay, this is the kernel and this is the pericarp, fleshy layer. Okay, mesocarp. This is called as mesocarp. Okay, this is kernel. The fruit takes 5 to 6 months to mature from pollination to maturity. Okay. Near about 150 to 190 days required, 180 days required for maturation from the pollination. A normal oil palm tree with start bearing fruit after 30 months of planting and will continue to productive for the next 20 to 30 years, thus ensuring a consistent supply of oil. So the plant start bearing fruit after the 30 months of planting, and then will continue to be productive for the next 20 to 30 years. Unlike other relatives, the oil palm does not produce offshoots. Propagation is by sowing the seeds. So the propagation of the oil palm is through seeds. Current scenario of oil palm. The oil palm plantation in Malaysia are largely based on the estate management system and smallholder scheme. Today, over 40 million hectares of land in Malaysia is under oil palm cultivation, producing 15 million tons of palm oil in 2008. Malaysia is the largest producer and exporter of palm in the world, accounting 34% of the world trace edible oil and fat supply. So Malaysia is the leading producer country of oil palm. And Malaysia is the largest exporter of oil palm in the world, accounting 34% of the world trading edible oil and fat supply. In Malaysia, 11% of the total land area, about 62% of the country agricultural lands, is devoted to palm oil. This is the orchard of palm oil. Worldwide, palm oil production during 2005 to 2006 growing season was 39.8 million metric tons, of which 4.3 million tons was in the form of palm kernel oil. It is thus by far the most widely produced tropical oil and constitute 34% of total edible oil production worldwide. In Malaysia, the trees planted are mainly Tenera variety, hybrid between Dura and Pisifera. So the varieties of oil palm is mainly three varieties. First is the Dura, then Pisifera and Tenera varieties. And Malaysia mostly most cultivable variety is the Tenera variety. This is the hybrid between Dura and Pisifera. The Tenera variety yields about 4 to 5 tons of crude palm oil CPO per hectare per year and about 1 tons of palm kernel. Climatic requirement: soil, deep permeable soil rich in humus, depth should be at least 1 meter. Okay, depth requirement is at least 1 meter and more than 1 meter, less than 1 meter. Optimum pH is 6.5 to 7.5. Avoid heavy soil with poor drainage, highly alkaline soils, and soil with more of gravels and sand. With poor water holding capacity. So basically, well-drained soil required, highly alkaline and poor drainage soil may be mainly well-drained soils are required for the cultivation of palm oil, and avoid poor drainage, highly alkaline soils with poor gravel water holding capacity. Okay. Then climatic requirement. Oil palm is categorized as humid tropical palm. Sunlight, it is sun-loving plant, require bright sunshine of more than 5 hours and solar radiation below 350 calories per centimeter square per day affects the growth and yields of the palm. Okay, so the climatic requirement of oil palm is, it is recognized as a humid tropical palm. Temperature, it prefers hot humid equatorial climate with a mean annual temperature is 20 to 27 degrees Celsius and temperature more than 33 degrees Celsius. Inhibits the photosynthesis. Ideal temperature requirement is 20 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. Altitude and elevation. Oil palm can be grown up to 900 meter above the mean sea level and below 400 meter. It performs better. Altitude is 900 meter above the mean sea level and below 400 meter. Okay, mean sea level, from the mean sea level. Then rainfall, well distributed rainfall of 2500 to 4000 mm. It can withstand high rainfall and 3 to 4 dry months in a year. Rainfall requirement is 2500 to 4000 mm. Okay. And it can be stand high rainfall and 3 to 4 dry months in a year. However, dry periods affects yield adversely with poor sex ratio. Cultivation of oil palm under a rain-fed situation may not be profitable. Okay. Rain-fed conditions. It is not profitable. Okay. So, oil palm is cultivated in irrigated area. So, that crop can be benefited for, or the that crop can be give rainfall also and some artificial irrigation for the production. So that crop can be more profitable as compared to the rain-fed crop. The varieties in oil palm. First one is the Dura variety. Have a low to medium mesocarp. There are three main varieties of oil palm: Dura, Piscifera, and Tenera variety. These varieties are classified according to the mesocarp percents in the oil palm. Okay. In Dura variety, the mesocarp is medium, 35 to 50%, and it contains thick shell around the kernels. It is not preferred for the commercial cultivation. Shell thickness, mesocarp is 30 to 35%, that is 55% of its weight, and shell percent is 30%, kernel 16%, and shell thickness is 2 to 8 mm. Okay, this is the composition of oil palm fruit. Okay, then Tenera variety, it is hybrid between Dura and Piscifera. Female plant from the Dura and Piscifera is the male palm. This is Tenera is the F1 hybrid. It is commercially or widely cultivated all over the world due to the high proportion of mesocarp. Okay, so the oil production is from the mesocarp. The composition or the content, high content of mesocarp from the Tenera variety, in the Tenera variety is 60 to 90%. Okay, it is categorized by the presence of thin shell. Tenera is categorized by the presence of distinct ring of fibers embedded in the mesocarp near to and encircling the seeds. Tenera fruits have a lots of pulp. Okay, pulp, that is the mesocarp, and the thin shell and big kernel. Mesocarp 60 to 90 95%, that is 74% by its weight. Shell is 10% and kernel is 16%. Then Pisifera variety, it is shell-less fruit and pea-like kernel inside. Okay. Embryo abortion is a common in this variety and often kernel is also absent. Pisifera is the shell-less variety and embryo abortion is a common in this variety. Okay, so that's why sometimes the kernels are also is also absent. The presence or absence of shell is genetically controlled. Dunera is the genetic constitution of SH plus SH plus, while Pisifera is SH and SH hybrid is the SS plus SH. On selfing or the intercrossing, hybrid fruit from segregate into the 25% of dura, 50% of tenera and 25% of Pisifera. Mesocarp is 19% by weight and kernel is 10%. Note, in Pisifera, seed propagation is not possible as many of the fruit do not have an embryo. Okay. Embryo abortion is a common in this variety. So that's why the sometimes kernels may be absent. It is used as a male parent in the production of Tenera variety. Pisifera palm are generally recovered from segregating population since direct reproduction of this type is difficult due to the scarcity of fruits with embryo and the presence of protective shell. So in the Pisifera, mainly direct reproduction is very difficult due to the absence of embryo. Feature differentiating fruit types of oil palm. First one, mesocarp proportion in a fruit, shell thickness oil percentage, average proportion of shell in a fruits, and average proportion of kernels in a fruit. So in dura variety, the mesocarp proportion is 35% to 50%, and in tenera variety 60% to 96%, and Pisifera variety 98%. Then shell thickness 2.2 to 8%, and 0.5 in Tenera variety 0.5 to 4%, and Pisifera, this is the shell less variety, so that's why shell thickness is not occur. Then oil percentage 15% in Dura, 36% in Tenera, and 25% in Pisifera variety. Then shell proportion 30% in Dura variety and 10% in Tenera variety. Okay. This is, and Pisifera is the shell-less variety. Average proportion of kernel in a fruit, 16% in Dura, 16% in Tenera, and 10% in Pisifera. Type of progeny is as a result of Pisifera, Dura into Pisifera, Dura into Dura, and Tenera into Tenera variety. Okay, this is the cross of three different varieties. Propagation in oil palm and method and system of planting. Germination period in oil palm under natural condition, it takes about 2 years for germination in oil palm. Okay, so germination period, very long period of germination. Natural condition, it takes about 2 years for germination. Mode of propagation, seed, and planting after care planting. Season of planting is May to June. system of planting. Generally, square system and rectangular system of planting are used, but the most commercially used method is triangular system. Okay. Three methods of planting use mainly square system, triangular system, and okay, two systems are mainly used, triangular and square system. But commercial method of planting is triangular system. Then age and stage of the seedling at the time of planting. 10 to 14 month old seedlings are used for the planting. Sometimes 12 to 18 month stage seedlings are also used for planting. At this stage, seedling will have 13 leaves and about 1 to 1.30 meter height with good collar girth. At the time of planting, the seedlings having 13 leaves and the height is 1 to 1.30 meter. Pit size 60 by 60 by 60 meter centimeter. Spacing 9 by 9 meter that can accommodate about 140 to 150 plants per hectare in a triangular system of planting, are also 10 by 10 meter distance used for the planting of oil palm. Fill the pits with FYM plus topsoil plus 125 gram of phosphorus. Okay. Seedlings are protected from rodents whenever necessary by wire netting 45 by 150, 120 centimeter, encircling at the radius of 15 centimeter from the base. So for the protection of rodent, it is necessary to wire netting use encircling with the at the radius of 15 centimeter from the base. Take care of maintenance during initial period of establishment. Manuring and fertilizer. FYM 50 kg per palm per year or 50 to 100 kg. Or 100 kg of drain manure, neem cake, addition of neem cake at the rate of 5 kg per palm is also beneficial. Then fertilizer, inorganic fertilizer, season fertilizer and age. Okay. In May to June, okay. Fertilizers are applied in two split doses. First is in pre-monsoon season and post-monsoon season. Nitrogen, phosphorus, magnesium, and in post-season, nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and magnesium. Before planting, phosphorus is done in a pit. Okay. In the first year, 200 gram of N, 200 gram of NPK are applied in pre-monsoon season, that is in May and June, and in post-monsoon through 200 and 125 gram of NPK and magnesium sulfate are applied in post-monsoon season. Then in second year, 400 the dose of fertilizer is double. In the second year, 250 gram of NPK and magnesium is applied in post-monsoon season. And second year and above, 600 gram of NP and magnesium sulfates are applied in pre-monsoon season. And 500 gram of NPK and magnesium sulfates are applied in post-monsoon season, September, October. Full dose for the adult palm includes 1200 gram nitrogen, 600 gram phosphorus, and 1200 gram of potassium per year. Deficiency of micronutrients in oil palm मैग्नीशियम एंड बोरॉन डिफिशियंसी हैज बीन ऑब्जर्व इन ऑयल पाम. मैग्नीशियम डिफिशियंसी, सिम्टम्स ऑफ मैग्नीशियम डिफिशियंसी, ऑलिव ग्रीन कलर्ड एरिया अपेयर ऑन द पिना ऑफ फोल्डर लीव्स एंड येलो कलर स्प्रेड्स डाउन टू टूवर्ड्स द फाउंड मिडरीफ अंटिल द होल पिना बिकम्स डीप ऑरेंज इन कलर. मैग्नीशियम डिफिशियंसी ऑकर्स ड्यू टू द हेवी एप्लीकेशन ऑफ पोटेशिक फर्टिलाइजर. When ratio is the ratio of potassium and magnesium exceeds 5, okay. Sometimes if the potassium is applied in heavy dose of potassium may be applied to the field. So that's why sometimes magnesium deficiency may be occur. Then boron deficiency, hook use, it is also termed as blind leaf, okay, hook leaf, or the bristle leaf, it is also called as blind leaf or bristle leaf. Apply 75 to 100 gram of borax sodium borate per palm, and we can also use solubor for the foliar spray at the rate 0.1%. Okay, so the main deficiency, micronutrient deficiency of oil palm is magnesium and boron deficiency. Then supply of magnesium at the rate 500 gram per palm per year in deficiency, it is symptoms are noticed. Borax at the rate 100 gram per palm per year if boron deficiency is observed. Okay, so supply of magnesium 500 gram if the deficiency of magnesium, and supply of 100 gram of borax if boron deficiency. Under irrigated condition, it is preferable to apply nitrogenous and potassium fertilizer in as many split as possible to increase the fertilizer use deficiency. Methods of application in oil palm: apply fertilizer at the base of the palm, leaving 1 to 2 feet basal area undisturbed. Depth of the application: 1 to 2 inches, and mix with soil. Basin management: size of the palm basin in oil palm. Widen the basin as when the tree grows. In the first year planting, the basin is make from 1 meter radius from the base. In second year, the radius is increased up to the 2 meter, and third year and above 3 meter radius from the base. Okay, basin space must be meant only for the oil palm and should be free from weeds and any intermixed crop. So the basin should be make free from weed and also from the intercrop or mixed crop. Spread fertilizer in the ring underneath the largest leaves, and after spreading cover with a thin layer of soils. If the plants are mulched, remove the mulching material and spread fertilizer, and spread the fresh mulch of dry herbage to thickness of 15 to 20 centimeters. Mulching is also used in oil palm. Some fresh dry herbage are also used as a mulching material. Then irrigation and cover cropping. Irrigation at the rate of 100 liters of water per palm per day, 100 to 150 liters of per pump per day, even up to the 200 liters of water per day in hot summer. It has to be provided during dry period to realize that the yield potential of the palm. So the water requirement in hot summer is more as compared to the rainy season and winter season. Yield increase in oil palm under irrigation is attributed due to the increase of leaf production, increase in number of bunches, better sex ratio, reduction in absorption, reduction in abortion of female inflorescence. This is the key points to how to increase the yield. Okay, if the leaf production is increases, number of bunches, increase the number of bunch, better the sex ratio, and reduction in abortion of female inflorescence. These are the responsible for the increase in yield. After 28 month of irrigation, increase was from 1 tons per hectare to 4.50 tons per hectare. Irrigation requirement is increases to the age of the plant. Drip irrigation, 4 drippers discharge 1/5 of 150 to 200 liters in 5 to 6 hours. Then cover cropping. Furaria, fasciolites, then calopogonium, myconoids, then centrosema, pubescens. These are the crops are used as a cover crop in oil palm. Then Mucana bractata, a cover crop introduced in Kerala from Tripura. It is not flowering under Kerala Agriculture University condition and propagate through the stem cuttings. This is the cover crop. Macuna bractata mainly used as a cover crop in oil palm. Seed rate is 2 to 3 kg per hectare. Establishment of cover crop, hot water treatment, 50 to 60 degrees Celsius, soaking of seed for 2 hours improves the establishment, results in a good cover. Rhizobium culture at the rate 1 gram per kg of seeds. Leaf pruning in oil palm. Development of leaves in the crown of palm is initially slow. Each leaf remains enclosed for about 2 years and then develop into a central spread spindle leaf before opening. A leaf stalk is strong and fibrous and almost 8 meters long. A mature leaf may have 250 to 300 leaflets, each about 1.3 meter long and 6 centimeter broad. This is the leaf pruning, that means the removal of removal of leaves from the plant. Okay, so the development of leaves in the crown of palm is initially slow. Then each leaf remains enclosed for about 2 years and then develop into a central spear, that is a spindle leaf, before opening. Rate of the leaf production in oil palm is 20 to 25 leaves per year. Each leaf will also carry 1 inflorescence. Okay, each leaf will carry 1 inflorescence. Persistence of leaves in oil palm, the leaf base adhere to the stem for about 12 years and longer and fall away gradually. So the leaf base adhere to the stem for about 12 years. Okay. Persistence of leaves, that means the plants, the leaves cannot be naturally drop down from the plants. The persistence of leaf is very high, that can be persist on the tree up to 12 years and also for a longer period. Front pruning in oil palm has influence on the yield and also hence is of economic importance. If pruning of front has not been attained, it results in interferes with pollination, both assisted and natural. Okay, if the pruning not done in oil palm, that can interfere with the pollination and visual assessment of fruit ripeness. Okay, if the on plants more leaf may be occur, and if you do not leaf pruning, so we cannot easily see the ripe fruit on the tree. Okay, so leaf pruning is very necessary in oil palm. Excessive pruning is harmful, causes reduction in yield. Immature pre-bearing period, removal of senescent and useless fronds which are laying very close to the soil surface. Annual reproduction in area in areca about 6, while in coconut 12 to 14 leaves and oil palm 24 leaves. Okay, leaf production mainly removal of leaves from the useless fronds, that is they are laying in very close to the soil surface, that leaves can be removed from the plants. And annual reproduction in oil palm is 24 leaves. Then adult palm about 32 to 35 top leaves are left undisturbed on the adult palm. Each palm produces about 24 leaves annually, that is 2 leaves per month. Okay, so the oil palm produced in a 1 year is about 24 leaves. That means the in 1 month 2 leaves per palm. Then ablation in oil palm. Ablation, that means the removal of young male and female inflorescence and bunch during the first 3 years of palm, oil palm growth. Okay, first is ablation. What is mean by ablation? It means that the removal of young male and female inflorescence and also bunches during the first 3 years, that is called as ablation. Ablation, removal or surgical removal of any parts of the bud. Other terms used for the ablation operation are disbudding and deflowering. Okay, this is so called as disbudding and deflowering. That means in the first initial 3 years, removal of buds and removal of flowers. Frequency of ablation. Ablation should be done at monthly intervals by cutting with the help of narrow-bladed chisel. With the help of chisel, you can done ablation. Okay. Then purpose of ablation. Economic processing by collection of few bunches in the initial years of bearing. Then leaf. Leftover bunches may rot and lead to outbreak of diseases and pests. Diversion of nutrient for palm growth from this bunch and inflorescence, and results in to in uniform palm stems. What is the purpose of ablation? Okay, so the first is uneconomic processing by collection of few bunch in the initial years of bearing. In the first 3 years, the plants are utilize more nutrient from the soil, and that nutrients are a diver for the production and growth of the plant. So that's why if you done ablation, that means remove the inflorescence and bunches in the first 3 years, that means the nutrients are used for the plant growth. Period of ablation, 12 to 26 months after planting. Sorry, 14 to 26 months after planting. Ablation can be commenced after about 14 months of field planting and continue till 26 months when it's about 70% of the palms are producing inflorescence at an interval of 4 to 5 months. Period is 14 to 26 months. Start from 14 months and till up to the 26 months. Okay. So this is all about